Such quiz channels are very much popular among the people. Whether they are adults or children, everyone enjoys watching them, and you can get to know about their popularity by their video views. And in these channels, you will get to see quizzes related to geography, related to sport, related to entertainment, cartoon games, politics, and much more. And when it comes to earnings, these channels are not behind at all. They are easily earning $1,000 per month, as per Social Blade report. So today, I will show you how you can create multiple choice quizzes, just like those channels. And that too, not just one or two, but as many as you want, all within just 30 minutes. Now, I will divide this video into three parts. Making a single video would make it quite long, and you may also feel boring to watch. So, in the first part, we'll learn how to create multiple choice questions, MCQs. After that, in the remaining two videos, we'll see how to create them in bulk. I will demonstrate the complete MCQ video by playing it and showing you the final output. So, subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon and select all notifications so that you receive notifications for upcoming videos. So let's get started. To create a quiz, we will need content which we can obtain from ChatGPT. How? So I gave ChatGPT a prompt that I am a teacher who teaches general knowledge to students, and I need a set of 10 questions with multiple choice questions. Now I'm going to show you just 10 MCQs quiz, but you can create as many as you want, be it 100, 200, or 500. The process will be exactly the same, and you will find this exact prompt in the description below that you can copy from there. So ChatGPT has provided us with this, as you can see, and I had also asked it to provide the correct answers, which I have received from here as well. Let's move on to the next and main step, which is Canva. After coming to Canva, you have to select the size of the video by clicking on the Create Design. Now I am taking the size of the YouTube video, but you can also select the size of shorts and reels. You have to follow the same process. Now after this, the blank canvas has opened, as you can see. First of all, we will add a background to our design, by the way. You can put any background in it. But for now, I went to Elements section and searched Spiral, and then selected any background from the video, and it will be automatically added in the background, as you can see. After this, you can adjust the page duration of this video from the trim option above. We are going to keep it around 10 seconds, so set it accordingly. Now go to the Elements section in the sidebar and add a box from the Lines and Shapes option to our design. We will change the design and color of this box and make it white. After that, we will adjust the size of this box a little. These boxes are basically for option A, B, and C, which we are going to add. After that, we will drag the box a little higher, and by clicking on this box, we will click on the duplicate option and add two more boxes like this for option B and C, and keep their position a little below each other. After this, again, go to the Lines and Shapes in the Elements section, and we will add a circle from it, and it will be at the top corner, and then adjust its size a little. Then choose the color of this circle according to your choice. Also add a border to it to make it more attractive. As you can see, then you can also choose this border color according to your own here. After this, by clicking in this circle, we will click on the duplicate option, and then another similar circle will come. We will adjust it right next to the first option, as you can see here. You can adjust the size a little bit, either smaller or larger, as you prefer. Then we will also change the color of this circle. After that, we need to add two more circles just like this one for the other two options. So, let's click on the circle again, duplicate it, and add two more circles. We'll position them just like the first option, so these three are all set. Now we will copy the first question from ChatGPT and then come to Canva. In the sidebar, click on Text and select Add a Heading. Place it at the very top, then paste the question into this box. You can change the font, font size, font color, and font type according to your preference. It's completely your choice. Next, go back to the sidebar, click on Text, and select Add a Heading again. Now we will type 1 and place this 1 inside the corner circle. Change its color to white and adjust its font size and color as you like. That's done for this part. Afterward, click on 1, duplicate it, and place it inside the circle of the first option, changing its name to A instead of 1. Now click on A, duplicate it again, and fit it inside the circles for the second and third options, naming them B and C, as you can see. Just make sure to properly adjust their positions so that they stay inside the circles. This is something you need to keep in mind. Now these three are all set. Go to the Elements section and search for Loading Bar. Next, go to the Videos section and select any loading bar that you like. You'll find plenty of options here, so choose the one you prefer. Now, when you remove the background from the loading bar you choose, you may notice a drop in its quality. This issue will occur with all the available options. The best solution for this is to select any loading bar, click on it, then go to the crop option, and crop it accordingly, just like the one you can see here. Then, place it in your design below. This way, its quality won't be compromised. So, that's all for today's video. See you in the next one.